MXMA.
MXMA?
Which is something you've never heard of. And Bisping will tell you he's never heard of it. But the idea is martial arts with a motocross bike. So in that sequence, you see when Xander's fighting, he's beating you up with his motocross. And we wanted to kind of create that unique style for Xander. You know, one of the reasons why the film is so much fun to watch is because we had so much fun making it. But the amount of fun that we had making it doesn't take away from how much effort everyone put into every aspect of it. There were moments when I would be doing some fight sequence or little thing in the movie and Michael Bisping would say, no, let's add this, let's change that, and bring some of his expertise. What happened was, I think, he's had more fights in the UFC than anybody. One day he's going to tell his story. And his story, his true story, is, in my view, one of the most fascinating and compelling stories of any fighter ever in any combat sport. But I'm not going to get into it. He'll tell you that.
Shut up, babe.
But there was a great power on set. There were so many great things that happened to people once they left our set because there was so much love on set. And there was something, I remember talking to him when he got the call. He got the call while he was filming. And I personally said to him, you're going to win this fight because that's how destiny works somehow. And he said, you know what, then you're right. I know I'm going to win this fight. But he'll tell you himself. Yeah, tell him, Mikey.
Well, you know, I think you said it all. Of course, you know, making this movie, the scenes were very, very intense. So because of that, because of how intense we were working, and then on the days off, we were doing the choreography, we were doing the weapons training. There was no days off, really. That kept me in shape, kept me able to do it. And if it wasn't for that, I couldn't have taken this fight on such short notice. So I accepted the fight. Everybody thought I was crazy. 10 days notice. I remember DJ saying on the final day, what on earth are you doing? And I'm trying to eat the donut. And he's like, no, take that out of his hand. And yeah, you know, I could thank Triple X because I walked off the movie set and knocked out the world champion.
It felt like a pure, natural brotherhood. I can say the second Donnie and I met, it must have been 60 seconds before we both started talking about our kids. And we looked at each other like, oh my God. So you do it all for your kids, and I do it all for my kids, and our kids are running around us, and we're giving presents to each other's kids. And it was so clear that we both were driven by wanting to make our children proud, really, with our work. And seeing, in Hollywood, I sometimes get a bad rep for being a perfectionist. It's something that's not always welcomed in Hollywood because you're always pushing people and you're pushing yourself to be the best that you could be. And in meeting Donnie and working with Donnie, immediately I saw a kindred spirit. I saw somebody that was unafraid and unashamed to strive for perfection in what he does and what he delivers to the world. So there was great synchronicity in that.
I'll just sing, I'll sing for you. Ya yo me cansé, no quiero ser tu amante. Te digo de mi parte que no aguanto más. Ya no aguanto ver el otro como dice que es el dueño tuyo. Me mata el orgullo. Él ni te sabe hablar. Esta la hice pa' él. Cuando la escuche quiero estar ahí para ver. Cuando se entere y sepa que soy dueño de usted. Tal vez suene un poco mal, lo sé y no me luce. Todo es por usted. Mami, yo me siento tuyo. Yo sé que tú te sientes mía. Y me noviecito tuyo. Eres un te caliento más, 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 te caliento más.